iron sights? I use heavy artillery.
My squad is my family.
I make this look good. Literally, this hair, this face. I mean, come on, you see it.
Introducing your champion.
I've fought nightmares all my life. None of you scare me.
Jump Master here. Good thing my buddies and I aren't afraid of heights.
I'm the Jump Master. I lead the way.
This is a good LZ.
Yes.
This might be a good place to land, but what do I know?
What do I know?
Let's go! Allons-y!
Long walk to the next ring.
Dibs.
I mean, there's not much I can really add to that, except I think you're absolutely right. And we looked on paper, how much of a mismatch is this between Spencer and between Nunes? Pretty significant.
Give it a
miss, Tim. Nunes had the reach advantage. She had the experience advantage. She had the fight better pepper. She had better striking totals, better striking defense, better takedown defense, better takedown accuracy. There was nothing you could really say.
Possible OST there. Gonna check it out.
Gotta hop up here. Choke.
If you go back and you look at her losses, particularly like the Kat Zingano loss, and then you look at who she is today, I mean, this is a completely different fighter. The only thing that really kind of holds up is the power.
Rings close. One more minute. Rings close. 45 seconds.
Looking for gear. I'll relay what I find. Extended light magazine here. Level 2. Ammo up.
Pay attention, gang. Not far from the ring. We got 30 seconds left. Basically knocking on the door.
Attention. There is a new kill leader.
Kill leader. Call him if you spot him.
In terms of the other 135ers or the 145ers, I mean, they're
It's not even doable to make a 45-pound dash that's even remotely competitive at this point.
You know, she seals up her intangibles so tight, meaning you don't see her tap out. She has a reach.
You're gonna have to be a thinker.
Care package touching down. They usually carry rare platforms.
In that rematch, but sort of trying to get the fight on.
Someone's got to take out the new kill leader. They're too cocky.
Let's get to topic number one, if we can. All right. So it is in the history books. UFC 250 took place, again, at the UFC Apex in Las Vegas, Nevada, in your main event, Amanda Nunes.
How about slide in here?
That was happy.
Did it totally at ease, BC. Go first, my good friend.
Sending out another me. Damn, he's good looking. Check out over there.
Dominant consistently, all you can do as a pundit or fan or whatever is try to concoct some scenario in which there's a potential that a fight can be competitive. This time it was home to quarantine, the ankle injury, the baby on the way, all that stuff moving up to featherweight for the second time in the UFC. But at the end of the day, we spelled out the
extended sniper mag here, level 3. Phoenix kid here.
In the end, that was what she flashed in spades going the 5-round distance. Yes, she could have stopped this fight and making a shoot up as early as the 3rd round, certainly the 4th and the 5th. But at the end of the day, Amanda Nunes, can't be rattled. She came off that top of the GDR.
One less flyer. Her speed's looking up.
Sending out my decoy. How about this way?
Eyes on the sky. Flyers over there. One less flyer. Day's looking up.
Recharging shield.
Charge tower there if you need a hit.
Decoy.
my shields a recharge.
Send in a decoy. Okay, wait, how do I know that I'm not the decoy? Hi, this is Dream Within a Dream stuff.
I see an enemy.
Already in the next ring. I smell victory. It smells like.
Care package being delivered. Arcstar out. Care package coming in. Awesome. Let's go there. Check out this area. Heard that. Roger. Treasure pack here. Eyes on the prize, ladies. We're inside the next ring. Care package incoming. Let's get to the LZ.
Being rescued.
5 here.
High rate of fire. Not much kick. Let's check out this area. Got an Evo shield here. Massive here.
Extended light magia. Level 2.
Round 4. Beginning ring countdown.
Extended heavy magia. Level
3. Sending out my decoy.
New kill leader. Call him if you spot him.
Recharging my shield.
Only two enemy squads remain. I love it. Was a boozle or something like that. Only one squad left. And bam goes the boozle. Oh boy.
Inside the next ring. Looks like that area's been compromised.
Contact!
Yes.
Sending out a decoy. 1 minute until close. Rings nearby.
Taking fire! Pop and smoke. Keeping it on last.
Opening fire. Giving my shield to recharge.
Man.
You are the Apex Champions.
Over there in New Jersey for doing what they did, and I commend Cody Garbrandt for an absolutely sensational performance.
And look, this will serve as a sort of a natural transition into our next topics, but what a gluttony of riches at bantamweight. I always tell you, lightweight, historically deep division, into the deepest ever. Women strolling, never gonna let you down. And you made a good point about the business.
You're either ready or you're an idiot. Race you to the MZ.
All right, I'm gonna be honest. I'm afraid. I'm really afraid. I'm just kidding. Nothing scares me.
This is your champion.
Oh yeah, master of the jump, right here.
How about here?
Eeny, meeny, miny. Yep, I hear ya. I'm the jump master. Duh. Can you feel the speed? Yeah, baby.
Vianne, this may be the last time you compete.
Let's check out over there.
Only fight the batters you know you can win. Let's transfer to this spot.
Sending out my decoy. There's one, right here.
Attention.
Rockstar,
first blood.
I'm not done yet.
Frag out.
Downed one.
Getting shot at.
Round one. Beginning ring countdown.
I got some bad guys here.
Oh boy, next ring's far.
Can't believe I'm standing still. We've got company. Enemy's right here.
Can do.
I'm not gonna lie, I'm pretty good at this.
I enjoy many things, but death is what inspires.
This is your champion.
Charge tower there. Expediting our abilities only hastens their demise.
I feel most alive when rapidly approaching my death.
Keep yourself prepared.
That's about as impressive a performance as you possibly could see. Look, you're not even
spotted a subject.
Reloading.
Putting an eye on this guy.
Introducing your champion.
My squad's gonna beat up your squad.
I'm the Jumpmaster. Ready up.
I am the Jumpmaster, which should go without saying.
A fool and their treasures are soon parted.
Luke's fall over there.
Charged out of there if you need a hit.
I love this part! Holy!
Let's check out this area. Not for me. Attention, first blood.
First fatality. Let the games begin.
Division, huh? UFC should think about these bigger divisions more often.
Backpack here. Level 2.
60 seconds until the ring closes. No sweat for me. Can you keep up?
Ring's next door. 45. Hustle up. Shield battery here. Optics here. Close range. Highlights your enemies. Shield battery here. Package incoming. Let's get to the LZ. New kill leader. Watch your six.
Sure are split up. Let's hurry up and we group.
Reposition here.
He made this fight. I had him on my shelf. I was like, how did this fight come about? He was just looking down the list about who might be available and interesting. Ralph Weiler called Sean Shelby and said, how about thought about it, called him back and said, okay. And that was the fight. And then so he just sort of understands how to make his own future, how to make his own reality. The last thing I'll say is, I'm not the most pro-USADA guy in the world. BC, I think you know that. And I don't, I mean, there's just no evidence that his suspension was in any way scientifically valid. They railroaded this kid. But here's the thing I'll say. You mentioned Chase Hooper. I mean, Chase Hooper obviously has a lot of ability on the ground and is durable, and the kid has a, which, you know, but has a ton of heart. I give him credit. But I just don't know if he's ready for this level, which isn't to say he can't get wins at this level, but I don't know if he's ready to thrive at this level. And I think if there's a little bit of work in the brace that he can develop physically and some of his other skill sets, that he can eventually thrive at this level. 2 years off, again, I don't want to call it good for him.
Popping the chimney.
He made the most of it. He maximized it. He didn't take any breaks. He didn't rest. He just got way better. And in his 20s, for 2 years, I'm sure he took bumps and bruises in the gym, BC, but he didn't get lit up with some bad fight in the octagon. He saved himself, and now he is screaming for a more challenging fight. He's earned it, and he's ready for it.
Yeah, whether he deserves the suspension or not, he rehabilitated himself, right? He's like he went to jail.
life and death is measured by suffering.
I'm already in the ring. Score!
Care package being delivered.